for you to discuss about digital marketing. I have to thank Tahur Engineering College, Priyadarshini ma'am, and Professor Murugan for giving this wonderful opportunity to share my views on digital marketing. And straight away, okay, we don't want to waste much of our time. Okay, straight away we will start sharing our views. So it's just I have done some research on this platform on digital marketing. So I thought it's the right time. It's the right time. I have to share this kind of information with you all. The reason is COVID. When you say COVID-19, so not COVID. We just see only in one perspective. Yes, most of them are suffering. A lot of issues are going. It's a big threat for us, and we are trying to overcome from this situation. At the same time, what COVID has given us in a positive sense means one thing: we should understand that the technology impact was very high during this COVID, because we were being in lockdown almost in all the countries, not only in India, everywhere. If you see, so people are there in lockdown, and they are not able to move around anywhere, and it is the only way where we can spend our time only with technology. And without technology, we are not able to live. That's a truth we have to accept, whether it's right or wrong. It's debatable. But the thing is, without technology, without especially on mobile technology, we find it very difficult ourselves to live. And this is the place where this marketing, digital marketing, plays a very vital role. It is not a very new concept, but still, if you see digital marketing as a whole, as a concept, okay, if you see people, now whatever we want, okay, just is I'm muted. Yes. Are you able to hear? Yes.
Yes, sir. You're able to hear you, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir. We are hearing you.
Okay. So, if you see that, okay, whatever we want, we can just get any information by one click. Earlier, for example, even if I want to understand the synonyms of a word, I have to go and search in a library, and I have to find what it is. I have to go to library. So many things are there. Many times we avoid those things. But today it is not like that. We just go to Google and we just type whatever we want. In just one click, we get whatever we want in this world. And a very popular author, Sid Godin, always says, marketing is no longer about the stuff you make, but it is just a story that we tell. So now the marketers are not going to sell the products. They are trying to sell the stories. What are the users, benefits, comparison, so many things. This is what market is going. And we people just buy only the brand. We people buy only the, okay, the qualities or quantities, all these things, not the product exactly. And the digital marketing is something we are going to use or involve the electronic devices in marketing. And I'm just going to give you a small comparison about how this digital marketing was impact with the traditional marketing. If you see just traditional marketing, we were using the newspapers, radios, televisions, maybe magazines, print media, hoardings, so many things. But now everything has been changed. Even I'm going to show at the end how the budget is also being changed from traditional marketing to digital marketing. How people are spending more time on social medias, maybe YouTube, or so many other digital media. This is a big transformation has happened. This transformation will have a big impact, not only in sales, it is also have a big impact on the cost efficiency. This expenditure is very high in traditional marketing, whereas expenditure is very, very low in digital marketing. I'm going to show you a graph which how this comparison. And the fact says traditional marketing is an assumption. I just assume if I give an advertisement in paper, newspaper, or a magazine, by seeing this advertisement, may or may not people will come and buy my product. This is what all traditional marketing were. I show a advertisement in television. By seeing the television ad, sometimes may or may not the customers will come and buy. But digital marketing is entirely different. It's purely based on data. Today, the data rules the world. Data, not only in marketing, in all the industry. In all the industry, irrespective of the industry, data is ruling the world. That's the reason Google is keep doing a lot of research. Plenty of money they spent on research and understanding about the customers, their need, requirement, expectation, and they have plenty of data. By just selling the data, they get huge money out of it. This is a big transformation has happened. Just we have a question. Why are people going online? Whatever questions you have, you just go and do it, Google it. And any information about new product, new services, any location. I want to travel to US or maybe I want to travel to Germany. I just go and put, what are the places to visit in German? I'll get plenty of information. What is the new product being launched? What is the new version next is going to come from Apple, iPhone? What is the next version I can get? What I want to know about an individual, what today my personality says, I can say what Rajinikanth is going to talk about, what Kamala Hassan is going to say, what any celebrity, it may be any Bollywood star, whatever Hollywood star, what they are doing now. Especially if you see a lot of videos are coming, especially we are very fond of cricket and what our favorite cricketers are doing, what Kohli is doing, what Rohit is doing. You can just Google and find out what the organization is doing. Just recently, Reliance has signed an agreement with Amazon. It's going to bring a big transformation. And this is what is happening in digital marketing. And any business contracts happening, any general information, especially job market, these are all the things people go into online and try to find what it is. So now, without this connectivity with the world, we cannot survive. This is the truth. And if you see, the objectives of digital marketing is very simple. I want to maximize the return on investment. How much I spend and how much I'm going to take. I want to find the right audience. Even the marketing usually always says, Flip Kotler always notify that marketing is understand the customer's need and expectation and fulfill their needs and expectation to the maximum extent, or maybe to surpass their expectations. That's what we say, delight the customers. If you want to delight the customers, we want to know who is the right customers, right audience. The information should reach the right audience. Earlier in traditional marketing, it may or may not reach the right audience. Now through digital marketing, they try to identify the right audience and engage them and motivate them. When they motivate, they buy. When they buy, it is going to make them return on investment. So simple, it's like a cyclic process. And the need, it's a five needs of digital marketing strategy. The need one says, don't waste the resources or duplicate the resources. Earlier, I just used to give advertisement in newspaper, magazines, televisions. I just duplicate things and spend too much of money. Don't waste resources. And try to make it very efficiently where it is needed, only to that particular customers, particular target audience, try to focus on them and connect with them. And for only those audience, try to use the resources. And next, keep track. When you focus on the audience, just track, go behind them and try to identify how their behavior is changing, what is the requirement. Then if you follow them, you may choose the right platform, whatever platform it may be. Okay, the right platform, digital platform, you can approach, you can choose and approach. Definitely your cost can be reduced and the profit can be maximized. There is a company called Hootsuite. This is a leader in social media management. And I'm going to show you some statistics. it is available on Google for free of cost, but just I want to highlight from the perspective of digital marketing. First, we will try to see globally and we will come to India as a country. Digital 2020 Global Digital Overview. I have taken only few aspects. I have not taken all the aspects. It's a very recent survey released by Hootsuite. And in April 2020, if you see, overall, the world population is 7.77 billion. And out of this, 5.16 billion are unique mobile phone users. Mobile phone users. Not any device, mobile phone users. And out of this, if you see, 4.57 billion are internet users. Almost, okay, more than 90% they use internet. And 3.81 billion are very, very active in all the social medias. This is most interesting. And the average, now please remember this, the average time spent on mobile by, okay, average person, in the global wise, if you see, it is 3 hours, 40 minutes. Just remember this particular time. When we see India, you can just compare how much an average Indian is spending time in mobile. It is 3 hours, 40 minutes, almost near to the four hours. And most of 50% they use for communication, mobile communication. And maybe 21% spent for some videos, entertainment apps. And 9% is for gaming. And maybe other mobiles, okay, apps for 19%. And out of this, during COVID, especially, this is the interesting part. During COVID, it has been increased. Smartphone mobile users is around 76%, and laptop computers 45%, desktop 32%. And if you see, almost most of them, they started using even the smartwatch. You have, okay, everywhere they want to connect with the world. That's why I told in the beginning, after COVID-19, everyone, how they spend time without connecting to the world, it's very difficult to live. This is the reality. We have to accept it. So almost everyone want to connect with the world. And what they do after connecting? 89% of them use chat apps, either WhatsApp, whatever it may be. And 89% still they are using all the social networking. Facebook or maybe a Twitter, Instagram, so many things. And 65% on entertainments and videos, 47% games. And in fact, the game downloads has been increased and new music downloads has been increased. And if you see, the health and fitness also been increasing. And as I told you, the Facebook users, social platform, if you see, more on Facebook, then YouTube, then WhatsApp, then Messenger, then WeChat, Instagram. This is the way it was going. If you see as a global trend during April 2020. Now let us come to India. How, okay, Indian digital market is looking for. We always talk about digital India. We want to transform ourselves as an digital India. How it is transforming. See, the total population is 1.37 billion. And the mobile phone connection we have is around 1.06 billion. Around 78% of the population have mobile phone connections. So still there is a scope for mobile phone market. And internet is only 50%. 50% of this total population, they have internet usage. And only 29%, they are very active in this social media. I told you what is the average time spent by in global ways. If you see, it is around 3 hours, 40 minutes. But if you see here, as an average Indian, can you see the changes? It is around 6 hours, 30 minutes, 6.5 hours. An average Indian, those who have an internet connection in any device, they use almost every day, 24 hours, around 6.5 hours, they use mobile technology. The world average says it is 3.5 hours, whereas Indian average says it is 6.5 hours. You see how we are, whether we are addicted to the technology or we are addicted to the social media, it is up to you. you have to come to conclusion, okay, how we are going to use. And we are going to see out of this 6.5 hours, how we are going to use this for digital marketing space. It is in general I'm talking about. And out of 6.5 hours, if you see, almost 2.5 hours for social media and around 3.5 hours for any videos, televisions, and for musics around 1 hour, 53 minutes, around 2 hours, and gaming for 1 hour. So this is the split of how an average Indian use internet. And main part of this is Google, Facebook, YouTube, nine apps, and Amazon. These are all the important apps where the average Indian people are using it. And total number of active social media users in India is 400 million. The change how they are using this is different users compared to the population is only 29% they use social media. And when you see from April 2019 to January 2020, there is a big addition of 48% increase the use of social media. In within 1 year, 48% has been increased. This is an interesting fact. And in India, if you see, more than Google, we are using YouTube. Then Facebook comes, WhatsApp, Instagram, Messenger, Twitter, LinkedIn, TikTok, and other people. A lot of TikToks are coming. A lot of people are using now. And it becomes one of the largest download app. And these are all the things happening in India. Now, when we just try to understand the use of mobile app by category. When I say category wise, already we accepted that we use mobile technology for message as well as for social media, no doubt about it. So that's why it is about around 85% and also around 70% for entertainment and video apps. And for if you see for e-commerce, it is around only 68%. This is where the digital marketing comes. And 68%, how it is going to be used, how we are going to make use of it. You see, in e-commerce, 74% of people, those who use mobile technology, they search online for a product. They search, just search. And after search, it may be any device, it's not only mobile, it includes a laptop or desktop, whatever it may be, any device. 74% of the people, they search online, and 94% of the people, they visited online retail shop. Out of 94% they visited online. And out of that, 70% they purchased product online. They have purchased. I hope I make sense. 70% they just searched online. Out of that, 94% they have visited. From that 74%, they purchased a product. And some of them, a category is given. Only 29% from the desktop and laptops, and 55% through mobile technology they buy. And what they buy, what is the value in dollar? If you see, around $12.5 billion, the purchase has been made for fashion and beauty, and $8.7 billion made for electronics and other medias, and $2.3 million for food and furniture for around $3 billion, and toys for around $5 billion, and travel and accommodation, booking.com and all those things, Airbnb, it's around $87 billion. Now it becomes a very big market. Booking.com, maybe I can say about Airbnb. These are the apps we use for travel. And this is last year, because if you see statistics, it is still January 2020. So the statistics talks about 2019. And if you see the digital music, around 242 million, not billion, it's million. And video games we buy for around 1.3 billion. So if you just see this category of expenditure made by an Indians, it is not a worldwide degree, it's made by an Indians. And the total number of people purchasing consumer goods online is 354 million. And the value of the market, this is the most important. The value of Indian digital market is 32 billion. It is 32 billion. This is where almost all the companies, they focus on this segment. 32 billion is available. And average annual revenue per online consumer, if you take average, it is around $49. Those who are users, $49 for average. It means every Indian, they start spending $49 in e-commerce for buying some kind of products through digital. So this is the market for every marketers to focus on. And if you see the source of the brand discovery, the ads on television, search engine, retail websites, TV shows, social media, websites, these are all the way where they are trying to reproduce their ads so that it reminds the customers to understand what is the product, what is the brand, and what. That's why at the beginning I told, they are not selling the product, they are selling the brand. They are telling stories to you. And we read stories. By inspiring the stories, we buy products. And the value of digital advertising market in India, it's about 6.62 billion. The total digital advertisement spent in 2019. In 1 year, the expenditure made on digital advertisement is 6.62 billion. And the search engine ad is around 1.39 billion. And if you just see the market, that's why most of them are interested in acquiring, coming to India to spend money on digital market to capture the customers. So as this statistics very clearly shows, today the online spaces is flooded with data. Data about customers. The data is about customers. So we as a customer, we provide a lot of our information, our interest, what our likes and dislikes, everything. We flood our data into the various platforms. If you take a Facebook, I upload whatever is my interest, what I'm doing, where I'm going, what I buy, what I do, every information I provide. It has been known to everyone. These are the things where the companies, digital marketing companies, they capture these data and try to make it as a huge platform. That's why I say internet population of the world is 4.57 billion, out of which 59% of population, they use this data. So this data is floating in world web, wide web page. Just I go and Google something, immediately my information is captured by Google and they try to sell this data to all the companies. That's what is happening. We are going to see all those things. Now, we will talk about the different types of digital marketing. When you know about the market, now we understand that the market is huge. We have to accept the market is huge and how they are going to attract customer through various ways. We have around 8 different ways, still different. I feel these 8 ways are very effective and utilized by most of the marketers. Most of you know what's called SEO, search engine optimization. This is what I told you. Every day, just okay, you can ask yourself. It's not a okay face-to-face interaction. It's through a digital platform. We are trying to connect each other. And maybe if you have been given the topic today, maybe your department or maybe Tagore in college, they given today, we are going to discuss about digital marketing. We have a lecture on digital marketing webinar. How many of you have just went and just Google what is digital marketing, number one? Many people might have done it. Yes. And at the same time, maybe if they given Okay, a person is coming from Subramanian is going to talk about this. Maybe some of you might have just have curiosity. You can search what it is. Who is this person? What is his background? That can be done. So immediately, every day, almost we just go and ask Google what it is. Something or some, okay, for some information, we ask Google. Otherwise, simple thing. Today, what is the COVID situation? This we do every day. What is happening? If I am in Oman, I will just see what is today's state. How many active case, how many have been discharged. And also, I always bother about what is happening in Tamil Nadu. How many cases in Chennai, how many cases discharged? What is the steps taken by the government? This is what. So I just go and ask such engine observation. So it means every online experience starts from search engine optimization. So this is the first way where we are going to capture the market. So 93% of the online experience begins with search engine. And we are going to ask only search. And we are going to talk about what is the medicine is going to take. Because every time, okay, World Health Organization is giving some kind of medicine for COVID, and they told, okay, this can be cured, this may be not good, and they are trying to change, and okay, we all get all this information. So through all the search engine, we get a lot of information. This is one. The number two, search engine marketing. When I say search engine optimization, it is a broader one, a common, whatever we do. But suppose if I put something in Google, in the first page, 10 results will come. How this top 10 results comes? That is search engine result pages. We always say SERP. It means this company is trying to give money to the search engine optimization, maybe Google, to make them to bring their company in top 10. So it's kind of something like a paid advertisement. So I just give money to Google so that Google, when you search something immediately, okay, it will come in the top 10. Maybe those who are not given, it may also come in search engine optimization, maybe in 10th page or maybe at the last, it may come. I always do. I'll just go and always search my name. I just put my name. Okay, what is coming? First top 10, what it is coming. And I will just see, okay, what is the way it has been. So what happened? This search engine marketing is the process. Mostly all the marketing company, they do. Because for example, I want to buy, okay, iPhone. If I just put Google iPhone near my place, and for information, the first result, the iStore will not come. You can just go and do it. The first, because usually people will say the Apple product, go and buy from Apple Store. But if you go and Google it, the first result will not be the Apple Store. Maybe some other, okay, retailer's name will come. You can buy from this, okay, retailer. Why? Because that particular retailer has given money so that they can bring that in the first page. But whereas the original, okay, the Apple Store may not come in the first page. Maybe at the end it may come. This is how the search engine optimization is useful for search engine marketing. Then we talk about pay per click. Whenever we just Google and we just go to visit any of the websites, maybe some ads are being there. We see a lot of pop-ups, ads will be there. And very interestingly, if by chance, if you just click that ad, once, okay? And if the advertisers pay just $3 for every click, and they may make you to buy for $300. Just see, they give for this search engines just $3, and how much they earn? Approximately $300. See the profit, the expenditure is $3 and the sales is $300. Now always, for example, if I want to travel from Oman to India, I always Google it. And once I Google it, a lot of pop-up advertisement will come. And I will just see, okay, which platform, if I book, the ticket will be very economical. When I just click and I just book it, for this click, they pay just $3 on an average. And from that, when I book a travel ticket to and fro from Oman to India and back here, they get huge money. But spending is very, very less. This is what we say PPC. When I say PPC, it's called pay per click. This is another media. Next, email. Everyone, that's the statistic says 91% of the people in the world check their email daily. Either it is an official mail or Gmail or Yahoo mail, Hotmail, whatever it may be, we always used to see what mails are comes. And we are flooded with so many advertisements, so many promotional mails. I believe everyone has been experienced in this. Even if it's official mail, even every day when I open my office mail, it's a Microsoft Outlook mail, I am able to see around minimum of 10 to 20 mails, which talks about, because as a teacher, we always interested in talking about journals, publication, research, all those things. And almost every day, we used to see a lot of mails from so many journals. We are journal background, we are interested in your research, we want to publish your article, so many things. As a student, if you just, Google it for some product, if you want to buy, and you may be flooded with these mails. But obviously, some mails, we may say it's a junk mail, we may not open, no problem. But still, out of this, some interesting mails may be there. And if you see the statistic says, 100 billion emails are sent and received every day. 100 billion emails. And some emails are being interested to me. I'm attracted to that and I will open and sometimes I may use that. This is where they are able to get market out of it. So they send newsletters, they send reminders, they send promotions. And sometimes promotion really attract you. This attractiveness make me to buy that product. Content marketing. Always we used to say the content is the king. What is the content you are going to give? Because now the customers are very well aware about the market and the product. And they know how to distinguish between the fake brand and the original brand. And they want the informations, very valuable, relevant, consistent informations. So the most attractive part of your website is about content. How you are going to make the reader to follow you. If you want to make the readers to follow, definitely content makes more attractive. And for information, now it's becoming a big business. The content making itself is a big business where people do a lot of research on content making. And they do a lot of understanding of customers and how to present that in a very attractive way so that the relationship between the customers and the company is long lasting. We don't want one-time customers. With one-time customers, there is no use for any company. It's only expenditure. When you buy again and again, then you are an valuable customer, a loyal customer. And when you be loyal, when you are not only satisfied with the product, you are also attracted to the content which is being available because you are going to believe, you are going to be very honest to your company. So content is the king. Then social media. Hope everybody has experienced on all these social medias. Facebook gives advertisements, Google, LinkedIn, all those. We get a lot of advertisements. And this is the place where the companies, the marketing companies, they want to play around. And they know, and from the statistics which I have shown earlier, most of them are connected to the one of other some social media platform. And it is very difficult, very hard to see a person which is not truly connected with social media. Maybe one person may be attracted to Facebook, may not be other medias, maybe not with Instagram or maybe not with LinkedIn or maybe not with Twitter. But any one of the media, we try to adapt ourselves to that. So what happens on everyday basis? Just tell me, even during this session is happening. It starts around 2:15. Now it's almost going to be 3. For this 45 minutes, be honest and ask yourself, how many of you have already checked your WhatsApp message? Or how many of you have checked your Facebooks? Or how many of you have checked your Twitters or maybe Instagrams, whatever it may be? It becomes, something like an addiction. And if I say, only if during a teaching process, maybe I may not see, but still, I just have my mobile side by side. Whenever I already put in silent, but still, what happens? The blinking is coming. So it means, some messages or maybe some information, some mail, maybe some WhatsApp message, some kind of information is coming. And my mind is also sometimes deviating. What's happening? Who sent this? So what happens? This is a place for any marketer. And we have to accept this. We are find it difficult to detach ourselves from social media. So any one of the social media, just imagine one day you switch off all the social media activities, switch off your mobiles and relax yourself. Then it's a big challenging task. Maybe you can try yourself one day. It's good for your health also, apart from digital marketing. Okay, you can try one day. You can spend time with your family and fine. But these marketers, they know that people, everyone, definitely they spend time in social media. So this is the place they want to promote their product and services. And we are going to show how this is going to impact in business. Finally, come to mobile marketing. Every day, we get a lot of SMS, MMSs, so many things. For example, every day, every weekend, for example, here in weekend means we always say Friday and Saturday is weekend. Sunday is a big beginning day. And every Thursday, I used to get message from McDonald's, pizzas, Domino's. And for information, I have never visited these Domino's pizzas at so far. How do they got my number? How they start sending message to me? It's direct, immediate. When I get some message, I just look into that. What does that message comes from? So immediately I see that message. Even though if I visit that place, if I visited McDonald's or maybe KFC or a Pizza Hut, then I might have given my number to them. Then they can send message. But I have not, to be very honest, I have not visited them. But still every week, every weekend, I used to get message. It means when we sign an agreement and get my mobile number, we always say that, yes, my mobile number is being transparent, being given to any of them. So the companies, they try to provide these numbers and I get. And this is one of the, because the marketing company, they pay money for it. It is ethical because when I sign, I agree that it can be shared with them. Maybe if I'm not interested, then I have to go to the telecom operator and say that I'm not interested in any of these advertisements. If I send that, then the telecom operator may not give your number. But obviously, we are not doing it. If you do that, acceptable. If it's not that, it is ethical. We should not say, no, it is an unethical thing. It is an ethical practice. They can share your numbers and through that, you will get a lot of information about that. Immediately, this digital marketers, they make this mobile campaign. Maybe one day or not, I may go and visit Domino's or KFC or McDonald's to buy something. Even sometimes it attracts. I used to think, because more than McDonald's, they also give some ice creams, fresh ice creams. It is very less costly over here and it is good. Even in winter season also we can take. So I always think, even if I'm not going to buy a burger, why can't we go and buy a fresh ice cream from McDonald's? This is the impact. One day I may also become the customer for McDonald's or KFC or whatever it may be. This is the impact of mobile technology, mobile marketing. The last one is about affiliate marketing. This is more interesting. You yourself can become an affiliate to the company, and you yourself can get commission from the company for recommending their product to your friends or relatives or neighbors or any well-wishers. That's another way. It's online sales, but through you, this online sales will be happening. When it is going to attract you, because even though they use so many other platforms, this affiliate marketing, something called as first join with the company. You yourself says, I am an affiliate for you. Then you try to promote in your social media. You promote their product, the company's product, in your social media. And through that, if anybody has purchased, and you will get money out of it. That's called affiliate marketing. So now these marketers, they are very clever. If I just put in social media, sometimes it may not be attracted. It may not be overseen by people. But as a customer of a product, if I put, okay, I use this product, you can also buy. So I will say, I use, okay, a kind of a smartwatch. This watch is very attractive. If anybody is interested, you can buy. And I already joined hands with this smartwatch company. And when I promote, and when customers buy through my social media, because data can be easily taken, and I may get money out of it. So even the customers also earn commissions by recommending product to others. That's called affiliate marketing. That's earlier we have this persona product, Amway product, Tupperware. These are all were there. Okay, it's not through online, but physically. Okay, if I become the member of a Tupperware or maybe Amway, I just go and sell this product to another customer. It's called, we always say, it's called MLM, multi-level marketing. It's physically happened. Now the same concept, now it becomes affiliate marketing in digital marketing. Now, let us come to, okay, the types we have seen. Let us see how, okay, a digital budget, marketing budget is being managed, how it has been forecasting. This is an research done, and the forecast has been done from 2018 to 2023. Now in 2020, we are here now. If you see the digital ad spending in billion, it's around in 2020, we always project that 384 or 385, approximately $385 billion spending. And if you see on 2023, in another 3 years, from 385, it's going to be $517 billion. The growth, expenditure on digital marketing. Digital marketing, digital ad expenditure. Okay, slowly. You see, just in 5 years, how this change is happening. From 283 billion, now it's going to become 517 billion in 2023. So people are focusing on digital marketing. And especially if you see in 2019, the worldwide digital ad spending observed a rise of 17.6%. This is around 333 billion. And it's keep on rising. They say it's keep on rising. And you see the internet display. More than now, newspaper, magazines are become minus. When I say minus, means the spend expenditure is going to be more on negative. It's not very effective. But still, internet paid research, internet display, internet classified, these are all going to rule in future. This is the projected is going to happen till 2023. Does it mean there? And where this happening? Which industry is focusing on? Retail industry. 22% of digital marketing ads spent on digital market, retail industry, then automotive, financial services, telecom, then consumer product, travel. This is the way you can just see how it comes. The health is the least one. Whereas retail industry is the highest industry where they spend more money on digital marketing. Even this reflects when I show the statistics where we buy more on, okay, retail industry, fashion. Who is the major global digital ad sellers? Obviously, we can see Google, Facebook, Alibaba, Amazon. Okay, these are all the in 2019. It is 2019. The ad revenue for this company, Google company, through ad revenue alone, it is $1.2 billion for Google. Only through ad. In Facebook, $67 billion. Alibaba, another big, okay, is okay, overperforming. Then Amazon, they got 30 billions. Amazon is only 9 billion. Microsoft, 6. You see how this digital ad sellers, they earn money just by selling the space and just spelling the ad. The top countries ad spending, usually in top 10, almost, we are in the 10th place. If you see US, China, Japan, UK, German, Brazil, Korea, South Korea, Australia, France, then almost Indonesia and India are at the same level in 10th position. We spend 8 billion every year. It's the statistics last year, 2019, the digital ad spending for India is 8.7 billion. Whereas if you see in US, it is $197 billion. See the huge differences? So they are going very fast away, but still many other countries, India is also growing much faster. Very soon, if you see in another 5 years, maybe India also come in the top 5. It's more possibility out there because this digital ad spending, because people are attracted to digital spendings. Simple comparison, in traditionally, if you want to attract a customer, I have to spend around 1,000 rupees, okay, $1,000 to attract a customer, whereas here less than $100 to attract a customer. Cost of reaching 2,000 audience. If you want to reach 2,000 audience in traditional marketing, I have to spend $1,000, but whereas through digital marketing, I spend just $75. $75, I can reach 2,000 audience. This is the most important information about cost effectiveness. Where is $1,000 expenditure? $75 expenditure. 1,075. Huge difference. But the result is same. 2,000 audience, I'm going to reach. Out of 2,000, how many going to buy? It's a different case. But just attracting customers, I'm spending almost nearly $1,000 for 2,000. So it means, okay, 0.5 for every audience. Here, just $75 for 2,000 audience. So expenditure is much, 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 much lesser over digital marketing. And what is the benefits out of it? Yes, obviously we have a lot of benefits, time, efforts, flexibility, real-time analysis, immediate feedback. By just whatever I buy, I can say immediate feedback. Yes, it is good or not. It is not as per my requirement. Every then and there, I can give a lot of feedback. It's more economical and more impact. Just imagine the previous slide, as I told, by $75, I can reach 2,000 means for 1,000, how much I can reach. So the same cost, I can reach many number of people. At the same time, the benefits also very high. The impact will also be very high. So additional benefits, as I told, is more cost effective. People start trusting you. Real time result, I can see immediately. If I show something, okay, especially through during this COVID, we try to buy from online and real time results we may get. And large corporations, they started using this. Revenue is also going very high. This is another interesting fact. What is the future? Not only future, but still, I will take another few minutes so that I can complete. You know about blockchain technology, voice search through Alexa, artificial intelligence, chatbot, influencer marketing. These are all the new technologies. This is a separate session we have to discuss. These are all already started. I will not say in future it's going to evolve. It's already been there. And especially this influencer marketing is going to play a big role through, this is called, we always say sometimes affiliate marketing also. I say micro moments. So very less money is being spent on digital and high returns are going to happen. This now almost everywhere they talk about chatbots and AI have a big, big impact. That's the reason now one of the technology impact, we talk about artificial intelligence. And this digital personal assistants, we have Alexa. Most of them start buying Alexa, and Alexa will tell you. For example, if I want to buy a pizza, immediately Alexa is going to tell you, based on your past experience, it will tell you what type of pizza you want, what is the flavor, what is the toppings, where you want to buy, and what is the size. Everything Alexa will tell you. You just say, I'm hungry, that's all. And Alexa will also tell you whether you are hungry, is going to satisfy through maybe pizzas or maybe burgers or some other food, fast food or maybe a traditional food. Everything will be helped by the Alexa. This is the big impact, and it will connect based on your previous experience, previous search engine, and this is the role where digital marketer is going to capture you. And before I conclude, I want to show you two case studies how it has been impacted. The first one, I think I'm going to play a video. Just tell me whether it is audible to you or not.
Stories about us. McDonald's is both famous and
infamous. Yes, audible.
We've been picked at, discussed, and dissected.
You are able to hear it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's good. Okay.
With food quality perception scores down, we decided to stop talking and start listening.
Any question, McDonald's?
Well, I would like to know why they don't accommodate vegetarian.
I'd like to know if it's actually 100% pure beef.
We listened to every question and answered them all openly, honestly, in real time, and posted live for the world to see.
I'm Hope Agazi, Director of Marketing for McDonald's Canada. And I'm here with a question from Isabel M. from Toronto, Ontario. She asks, why does your food look different in the advertising than what's in the store?
It'll be a direct comparison of the right side of both burgers.
Perfect.
We're trying to dispel this myth that there's a company out there called 100% Pure.
And Mika, the answer is absolutely not. Beef comes in two types, in lean and fat.
And instead of keeping the tough questions hidden, we made them louder.
In a new video that's gone viral, McDonald's is revealing why their burgers look better in advertisements than they do in real life.
Really, the message is the food is whole, the food is real.
You gotta have that Big Mac, and now the top chef at McDonald's is spilling the secret on how you can make that special sauce at home.
And what started as a national campaign transformed the way people feel about McDonald's around the world. We answered more than 20,000 questions, earned more than 14 million video views, and achieved dramatic gains on both food quality perception and brand trust scores. By opening up and letting them in, we made McDonald's a place people could be proud to love.
One more I'm going to show you.
Please.
Thank you. So these two examples of McDonald's and PepsiCo will give you a small idea about how they started using this digital media platform. And I always conclude by saying that the reach is the key to digital media, digital marketing success. So how far I have reached to the audience, then will give you a success for digital marketing. So thank you very much for a wonderful opportunity. I thank Nagar Engineering College for giving this opportunity. I hope have given some information about digital marketing and how it has been widely used. So maybe if time permits, maybe in future, if any interaction is required, we can do it. Now over to Professor Murugan. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. It was a wonderful and informative session. We had a lot of statistics about digital marketing. Really, it was awesome, sir. I hope every participant would have enjoyed this. I really thank you, sir, for your time. Over to our head, Dr. P. Priyadarshini.
Thank you, sir. So it was with very live examples, and you kept it very interesting on a Sunday, because you know Sunday is a holiday for us.
Nice.
And you kept it as very live. And even the McD example you gave was very right, sir. Even I have experienced that. So you connected very well with digital marketing. And can we post questions, or can we have questions from the audience, sir?
If anybody is interested, definitely. Hey, we can.
There is one question from Dilip, sir. He has posted it on the chat. So how can possible for digital marketing in rural areas?
Yes, it's a really a big challenge for every marketer on digital marketing. As I told you, it is not very far away, because now after this Reliance Jio, hope you all know about in India, in Reliance Jio, they have gone into each and every corner of every rural area. Just for your information, I'm just trying to say, it is not that the online purchases made is very high in metro cities. At the same time, it is not very low in rural areas. For example, if you take a very remote area, maybe I can say in Tamil Nadu, if you take Ramanathapuram district or maybe Sivagangai district, if you take we always say it's a very rural, remote rural area, where I was astonished, because one of my students was working in one of the companies where logistic company to deliver all these products. And he used to say, a very remote rural area, every day, for example, I used to say even the place name itself, it's called Karaikudi. In Karaikudi, they used to say every day, I'm saying every day, the number of delivery is more than 1,000 for one company. And he told it was a little 2-3 years before, and one company, and more than 10 different companies are delivering products to the customers. One company is 1,000 and more than 10 companies. So just imagine every day how many deliveries happened in a rural area. So again, so it's not very far away. Now almost everybody is connected, and it is very very easy way to get products. So I always say there is no big difference between rural and urban area. Okay.
Thank you, sir. As you quoted in the beginning, like how far the mobile usage is high in our country. Yes, sir. Okay. Even in Times of India, they have given a recent article on this digital marketing, sir. As you said, there was no difference between the purchase of women, like with respect to cosmetics and other things, from rural to urban.
Exactly. Yes.
It just 3% was different.
Exactly. Yes.
Participant, would you like to ask any question? You can unmute yourself and ask directly to our sir.
Maybe they are all in holiday mode.
Mode.
On Sunday.
Sunday. had nice food and
yes, already it's evening for the
evening time. Yes,
I hope we can end the session now.
Yes, sir, we can end up. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you.